Say this with me. Do you have a ticket? I don't care who it is, coworker, friends, or family. If they want you to fix an IT problem, they have to have a ticket. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to set up your very own ticketing system. Because if you're wanting to get into IT, which is the best job in the entire world, the help desk is usually the first step most of us take. And on the help desk, you're gonna be answering and dealing with a lot of tickets. So why not start now? Make everyone in your life submit a ticket for whatever issue they have. If your grandma needs help with their cell phone, ticket. If Netflix isn't working on your mom's TV, ticket. If the printer isn't working in the network check office, ticket. Yeah, Michael, by the way, the printer is still not working. That's the primary reason I'm doing this video, is because we needed a ticketing system. Because our stinking printer is still not working, Michael. Get it together, man. Now here's what you need to set up your very own ticketing system. We are going to self-host this, which means you will need some hardware to put this on. You got two options. Either you have some in your house, on-prem, like a server or a NAS or a spare laptop or something. Really just anything that can run Docker. Or option two, my personal favorite, the cloud. This is where I mainly run all my projects. And you already know my favorite cloud. It's Linode, a cloud computing company from Akamai. They made me say that, but still, Linode's awesome. Now I'm gonna show you how to set up both. It's all gonna be Docker based, so super easy and super amazing. If you don't know what Docker is, then watch this video right here. I talk about it a lot. Now the final thing you need is probably the most important, and if you wanna be in IT, this is required. Coffee, because, well, it's on my cup. Because everything in IT requires coffee. Now the first thing we'll do is get logged into Linode. Now if you're new to Linode, I've got good news for you. If you check my link below and you click that link, don't worry, it's safe. You can trust me. You'll get $100 credit for 60 days. So this project right here is gonna be free for you. Anyways, once you're signed up and logged in, like I'm about to do right now, we're gonna click on Create at the top left here. And please ignore all my Linodes, I've got a lot. I told you, I love this cloud platform. So click on Create and Linode. Now this install will be stupid easy because Linode has a bunch of one-click apps in their marketplace. So up here in our little tab menu, click on Marketplace. And here in the search bar, we're gonna search for a little thing called Peppermint. This will be our help desk software, our ticketing software. Now, this isn't the only one I'm going to show you. I'll tell you why here in a moment. But just so you know, as far as ticketing software goes, there's a lot. Like, if you've never worked on a help desk, there's SysAid, ServiceNow, Zoho, and like a million others. So one of my goals in this video is not for you to like know the ins and outs of every single ticketing software, but just to become familiar with the idea of a ticket. Documentation. And also put on your resume, hey, I self-host my own ticketing software for my family and friends. That's pretty cool. So let's continue. Click on Peppermint, and then we'll scroll down and just do a few things to get this set up. First, we'll choose our image. I'll go with Ubuntu, because I love Ubuntu. Pick your region, somewhere close to you. I'm in Dallas. And then for our plan, and this is what I love about Linode because it's so stinking cheap, we'll click on Shared CPU and look at our available plans. The first one right here is my go-to, the Linode 1 GB. It's $5 a month, 0.0075 cents an hour, or is that $0.0075 an hour? I don't know, how do you say that? Comment below. So legit, if you wanna spin this up real quick just to play with it along with me right now, and you leave it up for an hour, that's how much it'll cost you. Delete it and you're done. And at the most, you're gonna be charged $5 for the month. Anyways, I love Linode. Now that we have our plan selected, I'll scroll down just a bit. I'll label the sucker. Do you have a ticket? If you don't, put one in. Sorry, I got some PTSD from my help desk days. Throw in a password. And finally, click on Create, and we are pretty much done. And have you seen this new Linode feature, Create Using Command Line? So whatever you put in here, if you click on this, it'll give you the curl command for this and the Linode CLI. That's kind of sick. Anyways, I'll click on Create and take a little coffee break. While I finish this baking. Now, if you're like me, when you're baking something in the oven, you like to turn on the light and watch things rise and get close because it's nice and warm. We can do that here too. Up here at the top right, you can click on Launch Lish Console because it's delicious. Sorry for that. Click that and you get a really cool terminal here that will show you what's up so you can enjoy it while you're taking a coffee break. Okay, mine is ready. You'll know yours is ready when you see the login prompt here, and it's also running over here. Now before we test it out, I wanna show you one thing. Right here in the Lish console, let's get logged in. Type in root, and then whatever password you set. I wanna show you real quick that we are indeed running a Docker container. Type in Docker PS, and there it is right there. And if we scooch this over a bit, we'll just confirm our port's being used here. Yes, we'll need to know this. When we try to access our website, our new ticketing system, it'll be on port 5001. So let's do it right now. I'll close Lish, and now I'm gonna find my reverse DNS name, my RDNS. For that, it's super easy. Go to the network tab right here, and it should be right down here, reverse DNS. I'll grab that DNS name, copy that, and paste it into a new tab. Oh wait, forgot my port. What port was it? Do you know, do you remember? 5001, right? Colon 5001 right after that. There we go. And here it is. Nah, I got one big beef with this guy. That's clearly T, Shots fired. Let's get rid of that tea bag real quick. Much better. I fixed your site for you. Now to install Peppermint anywhere else, they have a great GitHub that'll show you how to do that. I'll have that link below. If you scroll down just a bit, Jack here will show you a Docker Compose file, which I will copy right now. And I'll open up a terminal in a Linux-based machine. Now one thing you'll want to make sure you have is Docker and Docker Compose installed. Easy enough to do. apt install docker.io, docker-compose, and then a dash y. Give it a sec, it'll install for you if you don't already have it. And then real quick, we'll do two things. First, I'll make a new directory, mkdir, and I'll call this peppermint. Then I'll cd into that directory, cd peppermint. And then inside this new directory, I'll make a new file, nano docker-compose.yml. Inside here, I'll paste some config, some YAML. Then hit control X, Y, enter to save, and then one command to bring this up, docker-compose up-d. It's gonna do its thing, which I love doing Docker Compose and seeing all the containers come down. I love it every time. Again, it's fun to watch. Now if I type in Docker PS to make sure he's running, there he is, port 5001. And then in your browser, just take your IP address on port 5001. Actually, it looks like this is gonna be on 5000. I was wrong. There we go. The other one was 5001, right? Okay, yeah, I'm not crazy about this. So that's how you do it locally, anywhere else. Now let's get logged in. The default username is admin@admin.com, and the password is 1234. Don't even change that, it's so secure, it doesn't matter. And here it is. It's kind of pretty, right? It's simple, and that's what I love about this ticketing system. It's not too complicated, and it won't take much for you to get the hang of it. So over here on the left, we have our dashboard, which we're already in, tickets, history of what you've done, and an option to create a ticket. And then down here, because you're an admin, you have options to change some settings, like create clients and users. So let's do two things real quick. I still have a printer in my office that doesn't work, and I want Michael to fix it. So I'm gonna add Michael as a user, click on users, new user, pretty straightforward, and click on save. And now with Michael as a user, I can now go create a ticket. I'll click on create ticket, enter my details, and assign it to an engineer. Michael, you're an engineer now, congrats. I'll set this to a high urgency and click on create ticket. Now if I log in as Michael, this is his dashboard, this is what he sees. He sees, oh hey, one open ticket, let me jump in there. Oh man, it's for my boss, it's internal, view that. And he can do things like make notes, maybe edit the ticket, add some activity, transfer it if you can't figure it out. So transfer it back to admin, and then mark it complete when everything is good to go. Now again, this is pretty basic, and I kind of like that. Like if you want to set this up for your family, your friends, you don't want something too complex. And I think this does a great job. So massive shout out to the creator of Peppermint, Jack Andrews. I think it's just a side project for him, but this is still pretty cool. I think we have time. I want to show you one more to give you some options. Now to set this one up, we'll want to get command line access to our Linode here, our virtual machine. So I'll get back to my Linode. I'm going to copy the SSH access command, copy. I'll launch my terminal and paste that command. Accept all fingerprints, put in my password, and we're in. Now this other ticketing software is called UVSoft, I think? Oh no, UVDesk. And a massive shout out to Marius Hosting for offering a pretty good guide on setting it up with Docker Compose, which makes things so much easier. Now he's talking about a Synology NAS. If you wanna do that, follow along right here, I'll link below. But all we care about is grabbing this file right here, a Docker Compose file. Now I've got my own little version right here that I copied from him. And here in my terminal, I'm gonna do two things. First, I'll make a new directory, call this UVDesk. I'll cd into that, and then I'll create a new file, nano docker-compose.yml. I will paste all that config, control X, Y, enter to save, and with one command, docker-compose up-d, it'll come up. And if you're like, hey, what is Docker Compose? What is this magic happening on the screen? I've got a video somewhere right here where we geek out about Docker Compose. It's so cool. Anyways, it's almost done. Quick coffee break. Well, it is done. If we do a Docker PS, I can see my two new Docker containers running, and it looks like port 80. Let's try it out. I'll minimize my terminal, get back to Linode, grab my reverse DNS URL here, and just go out to the port 80. It should work, I think, right? Let's specify 80 at the end, just to be safe. Oh no, not 5001. Calm down. Oh no, maybe it's 6744. I got it backwards. There we go. Now just a few things we have to do to get this set up. Let's begin. Cool, everything's good. Proceed. This is kind of annoying, but Mario makes it easy for us. Thank you, Mario. Server will be UVDesk_DB_1, port works out, that's good. Username is UVDesk, password is networkchuck, if you copied mine. Database is UVDesk. This should work, let's proceed. Good to go. It was just making sure it had a good connection to the database because we're running MySQL. And then we'll create a super admin account and proceed. Proceed once more and install now. All right, I think that's it. Now, like I said, this one has a bit more features, like a knowledge base. And that's one cool thing about a ticketing software that's worth its salt. As you solve tickets for your company, there might be a certain ticket you solved that needs to go into the knowledge base because you might see that issue over and over and over. So new people that come in, junior admins, or even other people in your team can be like, oh, I'll just search the knowledge base and I can solve that problem. So create your own little knowledge base. So looking at the admin here, I haven't played with this too much, but I know it's pretty cool. Let's get logged in. This thing is feature filled. You can do a lot. So this is for all you nerds who really want to geek out, which is probably a lot of you. But again, I'm not going to cover everything here. You can play with this and figure it out. That's part of being in IT. I was just showing you how to get there. So that's the video. 2 ticketing softwares you can set up yourself, self-host, and I'm actually running both of these ticketing softwares on Linode, which is pretty stinking cool. So yeah, be your own IT for your family and friends, but always say, do you have a ticket?